Did I press record? Hey guys, how's it going? Scott here from scottsbasslessons.com, and today we're going to be looking at the best women of bass. 10 of the best, in fact, or 10 of my favourites, and I'm sure that you'll have some in there as well. Kicking straight off, we've got a great bass player, Nik West, just killing groove. Check this out. Just great groove, and Nik's actually, you know, she's a solo artist, but she's also played with Prince in the past, and you can just see and hear what an effect and influence he had with her groove and her feel and the whole vibe, right? It just right out of that Prince school. And obviously Prince, you know, he goes back in his influence to, as a bass player, to Larry Graham, and you've got that same thing going on here with Nik. You can hear that Prince influence, hear that Larry Graham influence. Just absolutely killing. Now next up, we've got Divinity Roxx. And this was actually recorded, my friend Gregor recorded this out in Germany. I was there as well. We were all hanging out, had a good time at the Warwick factory. She's played with Will.i.am, Beyonce. She's a solo artist. She, Bella Fleck and the Flecktones, like just super cool. And she can sing and play bass great too. Just check this out. Some people are born to lead it, others are born to follow. Some people are born to spit it, others are born to swallow. Some are born to make rules, others are born to break it. Some people are born to dish it, others are born to take it. I was born to make this better, whenever, however, never will I. Let them take me, let them make me, cause I know it's a lie. I'm a rebel when I'm writing, say. So if you want to know what she's doing there, like, I can't get it bang on, but she's definitely hammering on these. You know, she's hammering on those notes, and then this hand is sort of like. Something like that. Something I'd need to sit there and figure out, but it's wicked. And next up, we've got Mohini Dey, just like technique for days. And she's been killing it on the bass for a long time. I'm not sure, you might have seen some videos back in the day of her playing when she was really young. Yeah, she's done some pretty cool stuff, but check this out. Let me just play that again. And she also had that. It's like a little guitar line she was playing, but she's obviously slapping that. So next we've got the amazing Tal Wilkenfeld, who here in the clip that you're about to see is playing a bass solo with Jeff Beck, but has also done stuff with like loads of other artists, and she's a solo artist. Just a standout, ridiculously awesome player. Soloistically, language-wise, groove, she's got it all. And this was years ago actually, but she's just absolutely tearing up. Check this out. Killing, right? Like, now next up we've got Esperanza Spalding, again one of my favorites. She's just absolutely killing. I can remember hearing about Esperanza when she She was playing with Joe Lovano years ago. Joe Lovano is a really fantastic sax player. And then since then, she's gone on to become like she's a superstar, right? So check this out. Just beautiful playing and great groove. This is on a fretless. Mega, right? When in doubt, add the nine. So next up, we've got Ida Nielsen. Just, you probably heard her playing around. She's, you know, on Instagram, and she's been around for a few years. Obviously, she was Prince's bass player as well. And just, like, every time I hear her, I'm just, like, blown away by the ridiculous pocket that she's got. Check this out. It's brutal. Just check it. Obviously got this sort of like uber slap ability, but it's like super deep pocket, and at the same time she's got this. Okay, so next up we've got someone who I can never pronounce their name correctly, so I'm just putting out there before anybody points out in the comments. Obviously, first name Michelle or Michelle. Niegancello? I've got no idea. Let me know in the comments how you pronounce her name. But she's just a killing bass player. And the first time I heard this track, it just absolutely blew me away. Just check it out. Just check it out. And she's singing on this as well.
Jesus cured the blind man so that he could see the evils of the world. Perchance blind, but dark thought overcome by the light.
Oh, so it's some. So the first time she does is, and then, just check it out. So next up, we've got the amazing Rhonda Smith, you know, played with a ton of artists, obviously here with Jeff Beck. She also played with Prince. I can remember if there's a Prince album, it's not an album, it's like a DVD. It's called Live in Las Vegas. She's on that. If you can get your hands on a copy of that, what a steaming gig it is. But here she's with Jeff Beck, doing a thing, going crazy. PRS bass, very cool. She's got like tons of pocket. I actually found this video earlier on as well, and it just shows it. The pocket. It's just huge.
Mm-hmm.
just so good. There's masses of attitude. Okay, so we're almost at the end, almost at number one. I should point out that this is in no particular order, right? And I'm gonna do some notable mentions after number one. But this is number two. I've hung out with Gail a few times and she's just stunning human being, stunning bass player, just really great to be around. And just the groove, check it out.
This is Gail Ann Dorsey.
Obviously, Gail plays with Lenny Kravitz now as well. Now, so can you guess who number one is going to be? I'm assuming that 99.9% of you will be able to guess who number one is. Got it? Put it in the comments. This is Carol Kaye. Obviously, number one. Carol Kaye has recorded bass and performed with just a slew of artists, all of them, all of the artists. If you want to go and check it out, you know, go onto Wiki and just, you know, Simon and Garfunkel, Barbara Streisand, the Beach Boys, Neil Diamond, like just everybody, a gazillion soundtracks. She was one of the busiest working bass players in her era. And I actually really want to just play you the start of the Beach Boys. This is obviously Good Vibrations. And then I'm gonna show you Carol talking about this specific track as well.
I love the colorful clothes she wears and the way the sunlight plays upon her hair.
Obviously using a plectrum, right?
I hear the sound of a gentle wind on the wind that lifts her perfume through the air.
See, obviously, Brian Wilson from the Beach Boys wrote it, but I was thinking, who wrote the bass lines, right? Well, here's Carol, and she's going to tell you, and she's going to play a little bit for you.
But he definitely wrote out some neat lines on the bass, like, for instance, I'd have never played that. I'll just go into this. That's a jazz walking line.
Unfortunately, there's not enough things on Carol Kaye on YouTube. I wish there was. Carol, if you're watching, we should do something with you. It'd be amazing to get something in the can and shine a light on some of the stuff that you've done in the past. So, notable mentions. I want to give a shout out to Yolanda Charles, obviously UK resident over here with me. Well, she doesn't live with me, but she lives in the UK. Hey, Yolanda, how's it going? King of Glick, I think it's Glick, I'm not sure. Taya Gray, Tanya O'Callaghan, hey, Tanya, how's it going? Frasier Belmar and Lucy Clifford. And obviously there's a ton of other female bass players as well, but I think we can all agree that there's probably not enough and we definitely need more female bass players rocking this killing instrument. So if you know somebody that's about to take up a musical instrument, maybe give them a nudge and say, hey, you know, you should look at playing bass because it's really, really an amazing instrument. Hit like if you agree, obviously. Huh? If you are not subscribed to my channel, it would make my day if you click subscribe and like this video. And obviously, if you want to find out more about scottsbasslessons.com, go to the website. I'll put a link down below and you can grab a 14-day free trial. So go check it out at scottsbasslessons.com. Take it easy, guys. See you in the shed.